My name is Srđan Popović. I used to be a student activist back there in the 90s in Serbia. I'm training groups across the world how to fight dictatorships and fighting for human rights. I'm also teaching in several universities, so I'm a revolutionary in a way, teacher, writer recently since this book came out, and also a big fan of fishing, rock music and a father. It started as being involved in Serbian nonviolent struggle in the 90s, the struggle which ended by bringing down the Serbian dictator Milosevic exactly 15 years ago in 2000. And there were several experiences in nonviolent struggle that we learned throughout the 9 years of this struggle. After that, we were invited by the groups across the world. In fact, people from 30 different countries thought that it is really good idea to learn how to build a nonviolent movement from Serbs, which was really kind of rewarding because Serbs were known for the, you know, its violent history. So throughout the course of 13 years now, we are meeting the people from different groups across the world fighting for struggle, democracy, freedom, human rights, anti-corruption, social equality, very different kind of groups. The book is a combination of their life stories, of their brave struggles, story of Serbian struggles, a little bit of science because it has a kind of academic background, but in the same time it's written as a very, very useful manual for those people who want to change the world, whether they want to change the very small things that they're very unhappy because their street is not clean, where they're fighting the big bad guys, people like Kim Jong-un in North Korea, or they just are uncontent with whatever around them, and it's really applicable to any situation from Bangladesh to France. When you look at the changes in the contemporary world, you will understand that both in non-democratic and democratic countries, the most important and most durable change have come through the means of non-violent struggle. So you will need the same skill set, whatever you're fighting for. If you're super uncontent with the mayor of Paris, or you're super uncontent with your miserable economic life, you lose the same skill set. You need to envision the different future. You need to build a unity among the groups that may help you. You need to plan and strategize for the future. You need to select the right tactics. Sometimes it really helps if you're funny. And you know, the only big difference where you're fighting in a non-democratic society and in democratic society is what keeps the status quo. In non-democracies, it's fear. So you need to fight the fear and you need to bring down fear. In democracies or corrupted democracies, it's apathy. So it's your key point is to move people from this apathetic position into the position where they're full of enthusiasm for change. Whether you're doing one or the other, the set of skills is outlined in the book. There is plenty of the people looking at the phenomenon of nonviolent struggle throughout the world. Some of them are inspiring individuals that trigger the major changes in their country, people like Gandhi or Martin Luther King or Lech Walesa or Nelson Mandela. Some of them are anonymous, brave people like students that were fighting Milosevic in Serbia, young people who were fighting Pinochet in Chile, people who are fighting Shevardnadze in Georgia. And in the same time, there is a lot of my private philosophy, which is very much tied to the Lord of the Rings and Tolkien, because I think the nonviolent struggle is the best way for common people, people like Frodo Baggins and Hobbits, to really fight evil and change the world. There is a universal advice that you can give to the people around the world. It works well in Serbia, it works well in North Korea, it works well in France. If you want to change, it has to be you. There will be nobody else to do this change for you. Speaking of France and Europe nowadays, facing several challenges, economic challenges, foreign policy challenges, but more of all the challenge of values. Now we are witnessing the struggle of values within Europe. I think there is a larger role for people power movements to overtake and prevent European values from falling apart. I think it's a time for common people to raise their voice and protect this ideal of Europe that we were struggling for in Serbia, meaning equality, tolerance and readiness to push in front, especially facing with refugee crisis and kind of the populist movements around Europe. It's the choice of the people whether they will take the stage and protect these values or leave it to the populist. I think I would be super happy to see common people like you and me changing the stuff and protecting the European values.